Hi, welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here. Today, I want to show you how to use ChatGPT. So this ChatGPT tutorial is starting from the basics, and I am aiming this at teachers because as a teacher myself, this has been an extremely hot topic. And I think it's important to get out in front of it and learn how to use it and to see the potential that it has and show your students that you know how to use it. So I'll be covering a number of different topics in this ChatGPT tutorial, things like the basics of how to use it, how to advance your prompts to get even more out of it, how to use the AI detectors, and even how you can beat the AI detectors to show that they think that it might be a human creating this. Let's get started on how to use ChatGPT for teachers today on Teachers Tech. So this video will be timestamped. So if you look down below in the description, you can jump to different parts of the video if you're familiar with ChatGPT, certain parts of it. And I'll put the links to everything that I'm showing you with the AI detectors down below in the description as well. But first of all, we need to create an account. If you don't have one, this link will be down below in the description as well. So I'm on OpenAI here with ChatGPT. I'm just going to go ahead and click try ChatGPT here. So at this point, if you don't have an account, you need to sign up. So go ahead and sign up and go ahead, choose your email that you want to go through. A lot of times I'll just pick the one through my Google or Microsoft accounts. Choose your email, go through, and it's a very simple setup here. The only issue is going to be is how busy ChatGPT will be, and then that can be a little slower to operate getting on and off. So I'm just going to go and continue. This is where I have to put my phone number and get a confirmation text. And just like that, I'm in. So you can see that it's an extremely easy setup to kind of go in, create your account. You can go through, I'm just going to go next and done. So here I have a brand new account. This is just the free one that I'm using. But I do want to point out here that you notice there is an upgrade to plus. So if I hit upgrade to plus, I can go ahead and upgrade my plan, which I probably will because I'm using this quite a bit to save me a lot of time for different things. But for this one, I'll just work with the free version here with ChatGPT. You can see that they give you some examples. They talk about the capabilities and limitations here. I'm just going to go ahead and give it a prompt, and you're going to see how easy this works. So to create a new prompt or a new chat, we're just going to go down here, and I'm going to paste this in right here. So it's very simple. Write me an essay about why pets are important for a family. So I'm going to go ahead and just hit the little airplane here, and you can see it start writing in a hurry. I'm not sure how I didn't specify how long I wanted this to be, but let's go ahead and let it write here. So it went through, wrote me this essay here, but now you can actually tweak it within the thread that we're in. We're not going to go to new chat. If I don't like, you know, maybe I want to make this a little bit more funny. What I can do at this point is go to this and say that. So I can say, make this funnier. Now, how you ask it questions is going to be important how well you get the response too. So these are pretty generic what I'm asking it now. So I can just go like this. And then you can see it start to rewrite this through here. So they're going to add like this. They're the cherry on top of a very furry sundae. I'm going to go ahead and stop generating again because notice that there's no citations to this. But you know what? I can ask it to add citations. So if I go back and just add citations to the essay, it will go through and you're going to notice that it's going to start to cite the information as it goes through. And I'm just going to stop it when you see the first one. So right here, you can see now it's adding the citations to it. So once you start the new chat, you can work within this. So I could say, make this sound like The Rock is saying this, Dwayne Johnson, and it would put that tone to it. So it's something to play around with. So try a couple ones, try the one I gave you, or try it with a different essay type and see what tweaks you can make as you go along. I'm going to try a different style here. I'm going to write a children's book here, and I'm going to give it some prompts. So I am going to go to new chat up here because this is a new topic. I'm not working within this chat. So I'm going to go new and I'm going to paste in this right here. So I'm asking it to write me a children's story about a hamster escaping from a cage and the adventure it goes on. And then I made some points. I just kind of picked random points that there was two hamster, it meets other pets, it gets lost, and so on. You can see what I wrote. You could change this if you want. So I'm going to ask it to create this story. So you can see it wrote this story in a children's way. Now I could go through and ask it different questions. I could tell it to make it sound like a 10-year-old to write this. I could say that add some spelling errors if I wanted to in this. But you know what? How I want to rework this? I want to turn this into a nursery rhyme. So I'm going to say rewrite this as a nursery rhyme. And I'm going to just click on this and we can see that it starts getting generated as a nursery rhyme now. So another thing you can do, you can copy paste in text inside of this and ask ChatGPT to sum it up. Or maybe you have students write a story and you copy paste it in and then you can ask it to rewrite this as a nursery rhyme or a different format, turn it into a song. You have lots of different options to do this. So as I said, you can use this as a thing to sum up the key points in articles. If you paste it in and ask it, you can even use this as a translator. So if I go back and say, write this in French, it will go back and start writing this in French. So just some other points I wanted to show you that you can add to this. So now you can see as we get more chats, they're recorded here and I can always go back to them if I would like. So I can just go back and forth like that. I can even delete them as you get more and more. But what are some quick ways you can use ChatGPT? Before I get to the more complex prompts, let's try some simple ones here. How about writing just a speech? So I could go in, ask it to write me a grad speech, inspiring students of the future. And you can see it will start to create this. So what's another thing I could ask it to do? Well, I'm going to hit stop generating here. I could go and ask it to write me an email. So write me an email to parents praising how well students have been doing in class. I can put some points in there. So even if it was a challenging student, I could get an idea. Now, the thing to remember about ChatGPT, it gives you a great place to quickly start with ideas. And that's how I like to use it. So you can see it's creating me this email that I could copy paste over. So I'm going to hit stop generating again, and I'm going to go to new chat again, and I'm going to paste in, write me a lesson plan for teaching about the cell for grade eights, just like this. But more if I was going to get more specific on the question, then it would even do a better job. So I'm entering in some pretty general ones now. But you can see it's creating the objectives. It goes through and gives you a starting place where you can go through and start from there. So you notice everything in ChatGPT so far is just text related. If you want to learn how you can create art or images with AI just by typing in the description, my next video is going to be about Midjourney. I'll put the link to it when it's done down below in the description and up above in the card so you can check that one out because it's crazy amazing as well. And if you're liking this video so far, please give it a thumbs up. It helps me in the algorithm of things in the YouTube world. But let's get on to some of these more complex prompts. And this one's not overly complex. So I'm going to go to new chat and I'm going to paste in this. So here's the topic. It's going to be how to study more effectively. And you can see it's a brainstorming. So you could use this to help brainstorming. So if I go ahead and send this, it will give you ideas maybe that you haven't really thought of just to help generate some more ideas. So it's going to give me a list for this. So another thing I can use is, how about using this for mind mapping? So I'm going to go again, new chat, paste in this right now. So the topic is going to be literacy devices. Create a mind map on the topic above. List all the central ideas, main branches, and sub-branches. And I can go ahead and it's going to go through and create this mind map for me. You can see how it indents it. It goes through. But again, starts the thinking for you very quickly. You can draw this out. But I just want to show you a different way you could use this. Now, another cool way that you can do this, you can actually have a discussion for this. So maybe it's going to be an interview discussion and you can ask it to prompt you for the question one at a time as you answer. Let me show you how this works. So the last two examples and this example came from Alexander Young, who has a YouTube channel. You can check that out. I'll put the link to his. I just want to make sure I give credit to where these are coming from, but I just thought these were a good use in education. So I'm going to go ahead and paste this in here. And I'm telling ChatGPT, I want you to act as an interviewer. I will be the candidate and you will ask me the interview questions for the teacher position. So now I just want to point out this right here, I put in teacher position. You could change it. This is what you'd want to change to whatever the position is. I want you to only reply as the interviewer. Do not write all the conversation at once. I want you to only do the interview with me. Ask me the questions and wait for my answers. Do not write explanations. Ask me the questions one by one, like an interviewer does, and wait for my answer. My first sentence is hi. So I can go ahead and send it now, and you can see it is starting to ask me a question. So you could use this for students to practice interviewer to see how their responses would be for each other. So hi, it's great to meet you today. May I start by asking you to tell me a little bit about yourself? And I'll just say, hi, I'm Jamie, a tech teacher, just like that. And it's going to prompt back. So you can have these discussions with ChatGPT. With this ChatGPT beginners video, I'm really just trying to get your mind thinking about the possibilities and showing you how powerful this is and how students are going to be using this to kind of better their work all the time. And it's going to be hard to detect this. I just want to point out one last thing before I show you some of the AI detectors is if I go to new chat, you can even get this to write code for you. So if I just paste this in here, write me a code in Python for a tic-tac-toe game, you're going to see that it goes ahead and opens this up and it's going to write the code here. So if you're into coding, you can go ahead and test this out to see. So I just wanted to point out that one other option, but there's so many different ways that this can be used. So let's go open up our first AI detector here. So we're going to start with GPT-0 here. So this is, I'll put the link down below so you can quickly get to this. Very simple to use. All you're going to need to do is copy and paste the information here and hit get results. So we're going to go get some of the text. You can also upload here as well. But I'm going to go back to some of the things we've already created. I'm going to go back to the why pets are important. And I'm just going to grab this right here. So I'm going to grab this here and I'm just going to go Control C over to GPT-0, scroll down, and I'm going to just paste this in here. Make sure I have I agree to the terms of service and get results. And you can see your text is likely to be written entirely. So they're saying this very confidently. And if you're trying to accuse a student of using this, you want to make sure that it would get a strong recommendation like this. So how could they beat this now or add question to maybe the possibility of this not detecting it as well. So I'm going to show you a technique that I found from a YouTuber called Success with AI, and I'll put a link to below to also to that. So what we're going to do here is go to a new chat and we're going to start a conversation. So I'm going to go to here and I'm going to ask it a question now. So I'm going to go ahead and ask it a question and I'm just going to paste this in. I will give you some information before asking you to write an article. Do you understand? So it's going to come back and answer me this, and it will say yes on it. Usually it's quite quick when it goes through. So you can see that it's understanding. And I'm going to give it some more information. I can tell also that the speed of this has gotten a little bit slower, so it can change during the day. I'm going to go and just paste another question in, and this is going to be the important criteria that I'm going to give it to rewrite what I'm going to put. So when it comes to writing content, two factors are crucial: perplexity and burstiness. Perplexity measures the complexity of the text. Separately, burstiness compares the variations of sentences. Humans tend to write with greater burstiness, for example, with some longer and more complex sentences alongside shorter ones. AI sentences tend to be more uniform. Therefore, when writing the following content, I'm going to ask you to create, I need you to have a good amount of perplexity and burstiness. Do you understand? And I'm going to go ahead and ask it, understands. So the next thing that I need to put in, step three, is going to be this right here. So using the concepts written previously, rewrite the article with a high degree of perplexity and burstiness. So what was the article? I could go back and I'm going to go and actually just copy paste it from here. So this is where I had it here. And I'm just going to take it back from here and bring it over here and paste it in. So I'm going to get this rewritten again. And it's going to go through. I'll just scroll down and I'll let it rewrite. And then I'm going to paste it in to see if I've beaten this. So a couple of weeks ago, this could be a lot of detectors. We'll test it out if it makes any changes. So I have some new text generated now. I'm just going to go ahead and grab a chunk of it. Sometimes if you don't grab enough of it, then it can't detect it as well. But we'll grab this much here. And I'm just going to delete this and I'm going to paste back in and hit get results. Your text is most likely human written, but there are some sentences with low perplexity. So it highlights this, but if you got this back, then you would be probably maybe questioning it, but there's a hard thing to accuse on this. So what I'm wondering is there are other AI detectors that can beat this. We'll try a couple different ones here, but I'd really like to know which ones you're using and have you tried this way to try to kind of get around them. So let's open up another AI detector to test it. So this one is from Hive Moderation, and I've had success with using this one and detecting the method I just showed you. Let's try to see if this even works here. So I'm just grabbing this again, Control C, copying, and I'm going to bring it over here, linked down below to this so you can test it out. I just need to paste it here, and it has to be at least 750 characters long, recommended 1500, and then just scroll down and hit submit. And then you'll see the input is likely to contain AI generated text. So, I mean, it gives you, this is just saying it's likely to contain AI, but it seems to be giving me a lot better result knowing that this is AI. So if I just go get something from my blog here, and I'm just going to grab some text, I'm going to test it out here. So I'm going to clear it again and paste this in. And this time I'm going to hit submit. This should say human written. So this input, not likely to contain AI generated text. So it kind of worked from that baseline of taking something that I know that was human written and putting it into this. So this is Hive Moderation that I was able to detect this. There's lots of different AI detectors out there. There's free ones, there's paid ones. I'm gonna do a different video where I dive into these a little bit more, but I'll put the links to some of them down below in my descriptions, the two that I just showed you. And I'd really like to hear from you which ones are working best for you. But again, the students are going to be able to find these too, and they'll find ways to kind of get around them. And this is why I think if you're showing how students to work with this and using it as a great tool to help augment their thinking, this is where it becomes really powerful. So I hope this video helped you understand the potential of ChatGPT. So I know there's going to be some challenges to this, and I see a lot of opportunities. But I think making sure that you stay ahead of understanding how this works and how to teach your students how to use it for those opportunities are going to be the important thing, because they're going to be using it anyway, and this is not going to go anywhere. So I'd be really interested to know all your thoughts. Let me know down in the description. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. Make sure you check out my future AI videos when dealing with education and teachers also. So hit that subscribe button. I'll see you next week on Teachers Tech.